Good afternoon once again. We sorry for the loss of recorded online interactive teaching as a result of the erratic supply of electricity in our country. And that is why I'm repeating what I've already taught online in the last few 1 hour or thereabouts. So we discussed about forms of government, which is a lecture three of the course titled Post-316 Methodology of Comparative Politics. I said under forms of comparison we have six. Number one, studies of one country. Number two, studies of two or more countries. Number three, regional or area studies. Number four, studies across region. Number five, global comparisons. Number six, semantic studies. Now, and I say studies of one country means that we are trying to study some, institutions within that country. Nigeria as a country. Now, we want to study, EFCC and the ICPC. We want to compare. Is ESCC more functional than ICPC, or ICPC more functional than EFCC? I want to say, okay, well, within Nigerian context, we want to compare Nigerian police and customs, which one is more corrupt than the other. Or we want to compare military regime, and the military regime to a civilian regime, which one is more corrupt or democratic or undemocratic. These are the things that we compare under studies of one country, okay? And furthermore, it is all a particular institution like political parties. We can say, okay, we want to compare PDP to ACN another, which one is more democratic and democratic another. Then we are saying that the militaries, the parliament, interest group, political process, decision making, or public policy, for instance, labor or welfare, policy in that country. That is in that country. That is what we mean by studies of one country or studies of single country. The studies of two or more countries, means that we are trying to compare, Nigeria and Botswana, or Nigeria and Ghana, or Nigeria and America, or what have you. We want to say, why is corruption more on the large scale in Nigeria, why it is on the low scale in Botswana. Is a two country study. Okay, we are comparing the two countries. We can say we want to compare anti-corruption agencies in Nigeria to that of Botswana or Ghana or what have you. And it is said that such genuinely comparative studies are harder to carry out, and they are usually more expensive in terms of travel and research costs. Hence, the studies of comparative policies do a case study of one country first, and later move on to study others and elaborate the comparison between them. Such a step is very important intellectually because it is in knowing and reading about two or more countries that students can begin to make their new comparison. We are saying that, as a result of this, the study of a two country, is very hard to carry out, monetarily, costly and all that. And we come to the regional or area studies. When we say the regional or area studies, mean that we are trying to compare Africa, trying to compare, Europe, North America, we are trying, Middle East, East Asia, Southeast Asia, and Latin America, and what have you, all sub-regional, all sub-regions, so to say, like Southern Europe or North and Africa, for example. I decide that such studies are useful because they involve groups of countries that may have several things in common. For example, similar histories, cultures, languages, geographic location, legal systems, religions, colonial backgrounds, and so on. And I said in the last lecture that before you can make comparison, you must look into the similarity and the differences. And I cited the example of comparing Nigeria and Botswana, the similarities are that they are located within the context of Africa, the two countries, and the two countries got independent the same period, 1960 and 1966, while Nigeria got independent in 1960, Botswana 1966, and they have the same, official language, which is English, and they have the same, colonial, background, like they were being, colonized by the British government. And in terms of differences is that, in terms of, ethnic diversity, okay, Nigeria is more ethnically diverse than Botswana. And Nigeria has over 250 ethnic groups, Botswana has about 5 to 6 ethnic groups. And in terms of how do I put it? In terms of complexity, Nigeria is much more complex, compared to that Botswana. And it is said that this may include studies of African, Latin America, the Middle East, like I've read out. And it is said that the studies are very useful, when it is being read out. And number four, studies across region. So studies are becoming more prevalent, but at more advanced levels. They are often expensive and difficult to carry out. One must know, or masters, and travel to not just one region, but two or more. Such studies might involve comparisons of the role of the military in Africa and the Middle East, or of the quite different path to development, of the East Asia countries and Latin America. Then number five, which is the global comparison. It is said that with the improved statistical data collected by the World Bank, the UN, and other agencies, it is now possible to do comparison on global basis. Such studies can best be done through the use of statistical correlations, but such correlations cannot be said to prove causation. That is, the economic growth causes democratization. There is a relationship between economic growth and the democracy, but the first does not necessarily cause the second. It is said that the sixth one is thematic studies. Thematic studies under comparative policy focuses on themes as well as countries and regions. For example, it is said that some scholars may be interested in the changing roles of the state in comparative perspectives in the process of the military professionalization as seen comparatively in the structure of class relations as analyzed comparatively, or in the process of political socialization. Others may be interested in such things as dependency theory. And the dependency theories of some countries, it is argued, is the process by which emerging countries achieve national development, or the newer systems of interest group representation called corporatism, viewed from a comparative viewpoint. From all that we have talked about the six forms of comparison, we are able to now have a very broad perspective of each one of them, and for us to be able to know the importance and the vital of a comparative politics. And comparative politics gives us kind of insight, critical insight, into the altruistic nature of one country in compare to the other. It makes us to to be to have a kind of multiple understanding of what is obtainable in one country in compare to the other country. And let us quickly go into the objective of why comparative studies is being studied. That is, why study comparative politics? Okay, number one, to capture and analyze the major political similarities and differences. That is number one. Okay, that is to capture and analyze the major political similarities and differences between countries. The task is to develop some perspectives on the mixtures of countries and variability which characterizes the world government and the political context in which they operate. And number two, comparative politics helps scholars to overcome ethnocentrism. Okay, what do you mean by ethnocentrism? You know, means that for the, you know, culture of ethnocentrism, you know, to be overcome. Okay, in the sense that, you know, one country may believe that its culture or its, you know, countries is superior to the other, or in its own country, oh, the corruption is at the minimal level. But when compared to other countries, such country who has had that notion ab initio, we realize that, oh, his country is not, you know, erased totally from the corruption table. And number three is that we study comparative politics essentially because it enables us to understand how nations change and the patterns that exist. And number four is that we study comparative politics because it is intellectually stimulating, okay? Since our effort is to make the study of politics scientific, it employs a rigorous and effective methodology. And in comparative politics, the very basic tool is a methodological, you know, tool, which is, you know, methodological instrumentation. And it also, you know, let us understand, okay, under comparative politics, you know, kind of, you know, empirical, you know, data, you know, validity, okay, when compared, rather than a situation in which, you know, a single country is being studied. So this is, you know, the reason why comparative studies, you know, is, you know, being, you know, carried out. So we'll go into lecture four, in which we'll be able now to look more into the studies of comparative politics. Thank you very much. If there's any question you want to ask, don't hesitate to ask a question, and feedback objectively will be given to you. And at the end of the lecture, we'll be able to give you mock tests so that to prepare you, you know, mentally and intellectually for your forthcoming examination. Thank you very much.